If you love Baltimore sports, you'll love WNST.net.
Heard of Steeler fans here tonight. Play the song. Play the song. Come on up, coach. Come on up.
Oh, mama, I can hear you crying.
Here he is, live from Pittsburgh. Now, this song is interesting because Styx sent a guitar, so I'm going to have you hold the guitar. It's part of our auction. Oh, they're waving towels at my event. Come on. Come on. Coach, thanks for coming. I got to get you a microphone. I don't even know what the heck I'm doing up here. We'll get one that's working. Here we go. How are you? Thanks for making the trip.
I am great.
We're going to get it on.
You don't mind getting me sick.
Ooh.
I am glad to be here with you guys this evening. It's an honor. It's an honor. You know, it's a funny thing, football and particularly professional football. I think we're all a little bit wacky, and I think those of you that know us would agree with that. We're interesting people and competitors, and you know, like Chris and his brother Maki, sometimes we find interesting ways to let each other know that we care. And it's kind of the nature of Nestor's relationship and mine. We continually insult each other. And that's why we're such great friends. I knew in an instant that I liked him, and I hated myself for it.
They all do. They all do.
I hated myself for it. And then when our wives met, it was over. We had no chance.
None. It was over. We both married up.
Yes, we did.
We both married up. So here's a Styx guitar. The guys at Styx have been my friends for 20 years. I used to be a music critic back in the day. Every time I see JY, I'm like, I loved Renegade. It's my favorite song in 1980, 82. Wasn't my favorite song. Then 20 years later, I heard it in your stadium. I'm like, that was my favorite band when the first concert I ever saw.
We play it just for you.
I know you do. So this is a Styx guitar. It's part of our auction. I just want to win. And he's going to beat the Steelers three times this year. Come on up, John Harbaugh. Come on up here.
It's exciting to be here. Thanks to Mike. You're awesome. You're a good man. You're a great coach and a great competitor. Coach Billick. I got to tell you about Coach Billick, just real quick. We came in 9 years ago, Coach, and the first guy that called me and welcomed me and congratulated me in that situation was Coach Brian Billick, and wished me luck. You're a great man. You got a lot of class. Thank you very much. I never forgot that. James Trapp, I remember playing against you in Philly. You were kind of a tough guy. Jameel McClain, not a better leader, not a better, not a tougher guy, not a better story. I would encourage you to learn Jameel's story.
I wrote about it in the book. Everyone's getting a copy of Purple Rain 1 and 2 on the way out. Jameel's story's in the book, so how about that?
Marty Morningweg, our quarterback coach. Marty, if you stand up and wave real quick. And then the head coach in South Florida and his wife, Tanisha, Willie Taggart's here too. Just some special guests. Just real fast, the great thing about being a coach and being a part of this is what the Chemo brothers talked about. It's about family. It's about being a part of something special. It's about being a part of a brotherhood. It's about the wives and the kids and everybody running around. Mike's five kids at the owner's meetings and getting to know them and his great wife. And you know, for 3.5 hours, we're battling each other. And then for about 30 seconds on the walk across the field, sometimes we're still battling each other, right? This guy's got a great handshake. And I suspect he's a pretty good tackler, too. We never actually saw the tackle, but he thought about it. And the great thing about it is it's competition and you fight and you battle and you wanna not like the other guy, and then you just respect him so much and you get to know him and you end up loving one another. And I think that's the beautiful thing about this. But that time, that first year, after the first year, when Coach Tomlin and his team beat us three times in 2008. Yep, congratulations. All right, yeah, it happened. And Nestor was there, and I was just getting to know Nestor, and these two guys were hanging out, having a great time. And the last thing that Mike said to me, after we shook hands and we laughed, he said, "I'm just sorry we didn't get a chance to play you four times."
Wow.
He said it to David Modell, too. David brought it up with him earlier. Yes.
I mean, I thought to myself, wow, that's strong, man. I was impressed, you know? And one of these days, we'll get you three times. I know we will. But it's about family, man. And it's about the opportunity to stand in that room before, and you know this, and have people come up to you and give you a hug and say, "Let me tell you what the Ravens mean to my family. Or let me tell you what the Steelers mean to my family. My dad and I were together when? We went to the 2001 Super Bowl. We were there. We were in New Orleans in 2013. And in some cases, that was the last memory they have with their father, their mother, their loved one. And to be able to be a part of that in sports, to be able to know that you're kind of in some way, when you share that with somebody and to be a part of that, that's what this whole thing is about. That's what sports is all about, right? It's about family. It's about being together and being part of something special. So that's what you are. And the caregivers that James is talking about, and friends and family, and writing the number down on that ticket, or getting a swab over there, and becoming part of that family. That's what it's all about. And I will say, I will agree with Mike. I didn't like you all that much, but I do love you.
That's true. That's true. Very true.
You know, with Nestor, it's kind of like, yeah, you know, okay, he's pretty cool. But Jen, you are special. You're amazing. You're awesome. And we love you. We like you. But we love you.
You tolerate me. I want you to stay up here. Coach Tomlin, I want you to come up. Coach Billick, this is not about Super Bowl rings, not about my love for you. This is simply about age, okay? You're too old, all right? You know that. To get on the registry, you tried. God love you. You're too old. Mike's already on the registry, but we're going to put him on again tonight, and we're going to put John on. I want the hero staff to come up right now. We're going to swab these two guys, because, John, you're right under 55. I looked up on Wikipedia.
Barely.
But we're going to swab you tonight for the bone marrow registry. Get my heroes up here. I need to have my swabbers. Come on up. Bring me two kits up here. We're going to swab two head coach champions from Baltimore and Pittsburgh. Talking about James not getting along with his sister. You know, we're going to save some lives here tonight. We're going to attempt to do that, if not ceremoniously, because he's already on. He might get a phone call anytime. But we're going to put you on. You saw the Bickle family. There's a chance we get some people swabbed. So where are my heroes? They're bringing you water. Come on up. Come on up. Give it up for the ladies over here who've been swabbing everybody all night. Saving lives. They came out. All those pictures I put up of your players, Coach, that came out every time. I'd sit and do a radio show, and these folks come. They swab. My wife and I ran booths just like that one in 30 ballparks last summer. We have representatives from Delete Blood Cancer here. They're the worldwide organization to help save my wife's life. Give it up for them as well. They're usually wearing red, which I like. Gift of blood, the gift of life. Tell everybody what we need to do to swab everyone, introduce yourself, and tell everybody who you are.
All right. I'm Kimberly Duncan with Delete Blood Cancer, DKMS, the world's largest bone marrow donor center. And it takes about 30 seconds to swab and fill out this form. So we're going to have them go on the insides of their cheeks. If you'll just go ahead and rinse out your mouth for me, make sure we got a clean palate.
Yes, you can drink beer and still swab. I know it's a key question. A few of you have asked. You can. First question I asked. 18 to 55, good healthy condition.
No major medical issues, no previous cancer, no autoimmune disease, no major medical issues. You'd be willing to donate for any patient in need that you were found as a match for?
Yes.
All right, then we're good to go. So if you'll just take that and go on the inside of your cheek for 30 seconds. Great, just like that. You got a good swab face. Show it to him and get it now. Right in there, good. Go ahead and drop that.
I gotta take some selfies here now, this is funny. Coach Tomlin on a registry. He's going to get a credit card to find out. Now, they tried to swab John back in the VIP room. I'm like, no, I want to do this on stage. We need a table up here, obviously.
Let's see Coach's swab face.
Oh.
Perfect. Look at you.
coaches called me three different times to come out to camp and swab every guy on the team, literally. And I talked to coming up the Lake Road with you last summer before Jen got ill. And Mike Pettine was allowing us to swab in Cleveland. Marvin wants to come to Cincinnati. So that's one of my little pet projects this fall, is to go to all the AFC North cities when we play there and swab. That's Christmas Day in Pittsburgh. You're going to have to talk to my wife about that, bro. You better talk to Roger Goodell about that. Let's pull some chairs out here. I want to bring Coach Focus.
If you love Baltimore sports, you'll love WNST.net.